Now let me just say a word about the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Last week, the CDC and the FDA both lifted their recommended pause on the J&J vaccine. The state of Missouri quickly followed by announcing that state providers could start administering J&J again. At this point, our experts in the Department of Health are reviewing those announcements and making plans how they will use 1,700 or so doses of J&J that we have in stock. According to the country's leading medical experts, the benefits of the J&J vaccine far outweigh the health risks. This pause showed that vaccination process is being closely watched by medical authorities, and they will continue monitoring all vaccines to make sure that they're safe. I'd be glad to take any questions.
Hey, Dr. Page, we have a question from Channel 4 this morning. Recently, Councilman Carter, a licensed realtor, made a Facebook post that indicated he could assist people with county assessments. Do you believe this is or could be a conflict of interest or a potential violation of the charter or county ordinances?
So the question is about Councilman Carter's efforts to help people with their tax assessments and tax assessment appeals. I don't know the details of this, and I don't know if it's true or not, but certainly people are working to make their, to have their assessments be fair, then I would encourage them to do that. If Councilman Carter is using his personal office for personal gain, that would be alarming, but we really don't know the details or how much of this is true.
That is all I got for this morning.
Okay, thank you.